73% of the population struggles from stage fear. And one most startling fact is, almost all of them rated the fear of public speaking about death, which means they're ready to die, but they're not willing to go on the stage and speak, which means it's so hard for them to imagine to speak on the stage. It causes anxiety. It causes fear and stress in 73% of population. It's hard to believe, isn't it? But it's a fact. A lot of research has proved this. Now, this fear of public speaking is also called as glossophobia, which 73% of the world struggles with. Now, the question which I want to answer in this video is, why is that public speaking causes anxiety or fear in 73% of population? Shall we understand this in the video? Yes. So I'm going to share with you three reasons why public speaking causes anxiety or fear. Let's understand this in this video. Let's get started. Let's understand the first reason. And the first reason, I call it as visualizing the negative outcome. What is it? Visualizing the negative outcome. Before even we take the stage to give that speech, the day before or a few hours before, we start imagining the speech in our head. And we imagine ourselves failing on the stage. In fact, we see ourselves on the stage failing in front of this audience. We see audience making fun of us. We see audience talking negative about us. We see audience not happy listening to us. We start visualizing things in a negative way in our head, in our imagination. And we do it the day before the presentation. In fact, we do it last few hours before the presentations. In fact, that is the last thought running in our head when you're going on the stage. Now, this is one of the biggest reasons why that public speaking causes fear. Because you're using the power of mind, which is very powerful, okay? Using the power of mind, using the power of imagination to work against you. You start visualizing the outcome against you instead of in favor with you. And all of us do it. And it is very natural. It's a very natural phenomena that you start thinking negative about a situation. And the reason for that is your body is trying to save you, because speaking on the stage is a position of judgment and your body doesn't want you to go there. So body starts creating those negative images in front of you. And you buy that images and then you feel nervous or anxious. Now, this is the big understanding which I want you guys to take in this video or have in this video. Before you take on the stage, it's up to you. It's your choice what kind of outcome you want to imagine. By default, we imagine negative outcome. I want you to choose, consciously choose to visualize positive before even you take the stage. Just close your eyes and visualize yourself on the stage, speaking comfortably and confidently with an open hand, with a big smile on your face. Audience are enjoying your speech. Just have that vision in your head. Before the last 1 hour, before the last day, start visualizing positive emotions on the stage. Making sense? Just by changing the image in your head before you take the stage, you will see the anxiety going a lot down. You will see the nervousness going down. Don't make your imagination work against you. Make your imagination work for you by visualizing the desired outcome, not visualizing the undesired outcome. Making sense? So that's the first reason why people feel nervous, because they start visualizing the negative outcome. Stop doing this. That's the first tip. Second reason for getting nervous or anxious on the stage is called as being self-obsessed. Now, what is being self-obsessed? I've seen majority of the people, when they go on the stage, their only concern is, am I good enough? Am I looking good enough? Am I prepared enough? Will this speech help me to grow in my career? Will I get my promotion? Will they like me? The person who is speaking on the stage is so much thinking only about him. He's self-obsessed or she's self-obsessed. When you think only about you, you are being selfish. And when we are being selfish, people figure it out. Which means you're speaking on the stage for your gain. And people are intelligent. Audience is intelligent and wise to understand this. So please understand, the intention matters. When you are speaking on the stage for your personal gain, which means you are self-obsessed, the anxiety increases because you are living in your head just worrying about you. I request you, humble request, just make that focus go from inside you to outside of you. Instead of focusing on you, focus on the audience. Just ask yourself, how can I help my audience? How I can serve my audience? What kind of value I can give to them? How this value can change their life? How can I give them some knowledge which can help them to grow in their career? Now, if you make them as a center point instead of you as the center of your speech, you lose your anxiousness, you lose your nervousness. You feel light. You feel the burden is shifted. Because you're not doing it for your selfish gain, you're doing this to help them. Making sense? And when we are helping someone, we are not nervous, we are not anxious. We are nervous when we're doing something for our own profit or our own benefit. So just shift that mindset, okay? Instead of taking from people for your personal gain, start giving to the people. Start speaking to add value. Don't be self-obsessed. Be obsessed to help the audience. Making sense? That's the second reason why majority of the people get nervous, because they are only thinking about them. Forget you, focus on them, you'll reduce your nervousness and anxiousness. I promise you this. That's the second tip. Third reason why people get anxious or nervous before going on the stage is because how they manage their state. Now repeat after me if possible, okay? Manage your state before taking the stage. Once again, manage your physical state before you take the stage. I've seen many professionals, before they go on the stage, they have sluggish body language. They have a low body language. Their hands are low. Their body is low. Head is low. They keep moving restlessly here and there. They look sluggish. They look low with their body language. And please understand, your body language, your body, the state in which you are in before going on the stage, it matters. See, when generally you are nervous, or generally when you are sad, the body automatically becomes small, isn't it? Like, for example, if I'm sad, my body becomes small. But when I'm happy, my body becomes big. Okay, my body becomes, you know, it occupies more space. My hands are more open. A smile is there on my face. I look big just because I am in a happy state. So there are two states. One is a state of abundance, state of happiness, or there is a state of lack or fear. When you live in a physical state of fear, you become small. Okay, you become sluggish. You become lazy. You act restless. And I have seen many people, before they go on the stage, they are in low state. They are in physical low state, which means the body is low, the head is low. There's no energy and enthusiasm in their body visible when they go on the stage. So I request and recommend you, before you go on the stage, to avoid that nervousness. Change your physical state. How can you do it? Just jump. Do some jumps, okay? Do some push-ups if required, if it is possible. Do some deep breathing. Change your physical state. When you change your physical state, when you are big with your body language, when you occupy more space, when you have a smile on your face, when you have deep breathing going on, when you're in the peak state, the chance of you getting nervous reduces. The chance of you becoming anxious reduces. So these three are the traps which we fall in generally. Okay? So what is the step number one? Visualize. Don't visualize the negative outcome. Visualize the positive outcome. That's step number one. Step number two, don't be self-obsessed. Don't keep thinking only about you. Don't worry about you. You're speaking to help them, to add value to the audience. Okay, that's the step number two. Okay, and step number three, which we understood, be in a positive state before you take the stage. Be in a positive state. Be in a peak state before you take the stage. Which means do some push-ups, do some jumps, climb some steps, or do some deep breathing before you go and speak on the stage. So these three things, if you take care, my friends, you will see the nervousness going down drastically. And you will be able to enjoy the time you speak on the stage. This is the secret which very few people will share with you. But I hope and wish that you apply this in your career and see a good, amazing speech as an outcome because of this application of this research. Yeah, I'm sure you're going to apply this. And please share in the comment section if you have anything specific to know or you have anything specific to ask me. I'll record a video for that. Yeah. See you all in the next video. If you like the video, please subscribe. It was a pleasure speaking to you all. Thank you so much.